Thakoor and that's my partner Chandran Thakoor. We started this company 18 years back with a focus to promote adventure tourism and customized holidays to discerning travelers. It's like a passion, you know. Travel is a passion for us, wherein it's a bug. So we ourselves personally love to travel, and for us the energy is wherein we like to take people for traveling. When that experience comes as a wow, memorable experience, that is what we look forward for adventure as well as for travel.
Yeah, that's correct. People always look forward to somebody who has got the knowledge of the area, the location, the geographical part of the area where people have to travel. And after a lot of traveling, we got that kind of experience where we can share these things with the people. And then how do that people probably go on traveling? That's it.
I would list out a lot of things. First is treks. That's treks in the Sayadri and treks in the Himalayas. In earlier days, for Sayadri treks, there used to be groups which are going just to see how many people who just go to the fort and come back. But you have to realize there's a lot of historic importance to the forts. Take a knowledgeable historian and see the fort. Currently, schools are doing that wherein Chandan has gone as a historian to give information about the fort. Now, little change in the trend is not about reaching on top of the hill. It is about the experience. In Himalayan treks, we have like I earlier mentioned, from amateur treks to your high-end tough treks that are there. Himalayas offers you all kind of variety. So we are lucky that we have that in the northern part. Whenever you are doing Himalayan treks, please take care that you understand the participant properly and brief him how he has to prepare for this. In adventure, we also take jungle safaris. Jungle safaris, you have to make sure your client is the kind who's ready to sit there. It's not a zoo, so you have to wait for that. So educate them about these things and plan a jungle safari. When they say sports, in India, you have a lot of, we call it sports and activities. When I say activities, like your rappelling, rock climbing, zip line, these are more which happen in North and in Maharashtra as well. In Maharashtra, it is more with groups. In the northern region, you could go and individually join also because there are set places for these activities. In adventure activities, you have rafting. Starting from your, in Maharashtra, Kolar, which is a backwater water flow, that is a basic level rafting, to going to your northern, your Jhanskar River or your Ganges, which is interesting and where you can camp for 3 to 4 days and enjoy rafting at different stages. You have even in the eastern part where we have opened certain rafting and they are open. We started promoting that also because nowadays everybody wants something new. I've done Rishikesh, now next one. Scuba diving. You have Andaman, Goa, these places where you could go and learn. You want to do just a pleasure ride, you can give a half a day pleasure dive also. You want to do a paddy certified dive, that is also available in India. Skiing courses are there. You must have heard about Ollie, where they do long, I mean there are 10 and 14 day courses. Like we currently, people don't have so much time, like to be fair. So we do shorter courses, then 3 to 4 days you can learn basic skiing. So skiing, heli skiing is also available in India. Indians don't know it so often, more foreign ones do it, but that's also available. Skydiving is also available. Hot air ballooning in India, there is paragliding, parasailing. You list out, cycling has become a new passion. You know, like marathon is picked up, similarly, cycling is now the thing. Like, if the time in Ladakh, you used to look out for motorcycles, you have bullets to go. Now, in a day, you see 300, 400 bullets. Now, the fascination is if you see a cyclist going up from Ladakh to Thakoor. So, cycling has become another passion. Angling, fishing, yacht, how to this surfing. So there are a lot of adventure sports that are available. As a hobby you can do, or you can also do as for learning as well. This becomes the adventure sports. Children camps, summer camps. That's something for the last 5-6 years which is very popular. parents want children to do outdoor activities and learn from them. When you say adventure activities, they start from Mathura, Ambagad in Maharashtra to northern section as well. Generally, it is individual children who join into the camp, but that's another adventure part of it. In adventure, you have property building activities where we conduct game and activities, team building activities that we are following. So that's about adventure. In travel, if you go to see, there are holidays, there, abroad, that's your general travel. But in travel also, there are a lot of deserving. When I say deserving travelers, is people earlier used to do 3 nights Singapore, 3 nights Malaysia, 3 nights Thailand, finish. 9 nights take one. No. Singapore is a place where you could spend 7 to 8 days, that many activities are there. And now that deserving traveler, when I see that traveler wants to experience the place, not just to take one place. So enhance your knowledge so you can also offer the new to the people. Japanese students coming into Mumbai. So that's another kind of issue. Generally, we say tourist guide, that's not it now. It has a different kind of level of respect. You can specialize in that and be a tourist
guide. Practically, when I was 9, 10, typically conventionally, students needed to ask me a certain thing or what to do. Here it was not all defined because I was under my that kind of a time wherein there are people who play and then come study and then come to school, come back and then play. But then typically after 10, probably my first play actually was after the 10th exam was over. I had cycled down to Fort Raigad with my father. So after that only it all started. But then again, it was kind of a gap of around 3 years. Because again, 10, 12, and engineering. But then that work was inside me, and traveled, and typically the adventure, more breaks. So because of my father, actually, I started doing my training. And then this is the history as such.
I finished my graduation in BSc Stats, got selected for a banking exam, LIC, but I realized I don't want to do a 9-to-5 job. And that time I got placed with Qantas Airways for a 2-month tech job. Within the week itself, I decided travel is what I want to make a career. Then I met Chandan. I worked for a few years, then I met Chandan, and that's where the adventure started. Just to voice out a small thing, we have lived adventure as well. We are the first couple who got married underwater with all Hindu rituals. So that's why I said the adventure started after I met Chandan. And we decided that time that in those days, you didn't have so many professionally organizing adventure tour operators. So we realize that hobby trekkers, hobby adventure people are there. But if a common person wants to go on adventure, he doesn't have the right guidance or the right agency. There are travel agencies, but an adventure agency is not there. So that's how we came to even forming the company, you know, where an amateur can also get the right professional guidance to do an adventure.
No, there are basically kind of four disciplines which actually keep it playing in the field of mountaineering. You know, we have basic mountaineering groups, we have advanced mountaineering groups, then we have search and rescue groups, and then mountain guide groups. Naval Institute of apart from doing these courses, there are again the most important thing is you should go out. You know, you should have that passion of going out in the mountains or do some adventure activities like skiing, like scuba diving, like whitewater rafting, and then one of the upcoming sports also parasailing, and then skydiving or bungee jumping as such. But then typically for mountaineering, for river rafting, for skiing, there are issues. And then individually also you can go on these kind of activities in the northern side of the Himalayas or the eastern side of India.
I would like to add to this. Yes, you should do these courses because you get, become technically strong. But in adventure or in travel field, your first-hand experience is the best teacher. So like he mentioned, after doing the courses also, you need to explore new places, you need to explore different activities along with the courses. Now for example, like he voiced out scuba diving, you should take a scuba diving course as well. You take a paddling certification or you don't take it, but that experience is very important, because when you tell the client, it becomes a first-hand thing. Okay, now there are, when I say travel, every place you can't be there. They say one life is not enough to see the whole world. But then study has to be there also. In those days, 15 years back, we had to actually refer to books, you know, to get that knowledge. There were not that many maps or books giving information about activities or destinations. Now Google Baba is there. So please do your own study as well, is what I would recommend to everyone.
Yeah, basically, I did my three courses from the Naval Institute of Mountaineering, Uttarakhand. Basically, the first course is basic mountaineering course, wherein they actually teach you rock climbing also, what they call as rock rafting, and then scenography, ice climbing. Basically, how to follow the techniques, the rules, or knowledge of knots, where you have to use those knots while mountaineering or when you rock climbing. And then how to behave in the high ranges, like what are the dangers or other things to follow when you are in high ranges, like and then how to survive this thing, how to set up your tents, how to cook your food, and then there are a lot of different techniques what we have teachers, whatever the journey is based on them. And then ultimately, the height, in case of emergency you require, and then importantly height gaining or acclimatizing that particular area. These things you have to properly plan, and then you have to actually plan the peak. and then come back to the base camp. For advanced course, climbing the peak is the most important thing. Or rather, climbing the peak safely and coming back on the base camp and to the instructor safely is the most important thing. For search and rescue, you actually being taught about what are the techniques of search and what are the techniques of rescue. All the courses are 28 days almost actually, and search and rescue is around 20 days. And wherein you learn a lot of different aspects of safety, plus the search and plus the rescue also. So depending upon the building, where they take the search and rescue course, you get to analyze yourself also, you get to enhance your knowledge about the first aid, because whenever you find a person, a search a person, then you need to give him the first aid, and first aid is not giving the medicine. First aid is you are the link between the first medical doctor or medical assistance and the patient or the victim. So you just need to keep that person, not from medical intervention. So what they have taught us this year also, and then rescuing that person from that particular accident spot on the way to the medical spot or the medical place. So all these things, and even in mountain guide also, we need to find the route, we need to plan the route. So there are a lot of different aspects for the use. So that's a, if you get that knowledge after doing these courses and implement those in your career as such, that would be great.
Two places we work, one is the office and the other is your field. I will cover on the office part because I look after the operation, sales and all in office. The day starts with your calls ringing with inquiries. We are planning. Most importantly is the planning part of it. Maybe adventure or a holiday. Understanding what the customer wants. Communicating with your partners across India or abroad at times. Suggesting the right things. Mailing. That's your typical office work that goes on in office. Excitement comes up when we have these group departures happening for your skiing or your scuba diving activities, preparing them, telling them what to plan, meeting with the client and educating him how he should prepare for an adventure tour. So that's how a day in office goes. And in season times, there are times we work very long hours, which is something everybody should be ready. It happens in every field, but in travel field, there is check-in time, there is no check-out time. So I think field Chandran will elaborate on
that. The on field, typically everyone is excited to do adventure activities or excited to move on trek as such. Importantly, getting them know the safety aspect of the base, on the trek, on the activities, what would be doing, then inducting them for the activities, the procedure, what to follow, and what instructions can be given from the instructors, and these instructions should be followed. So, we normally bring them in the morning after breakfast, and then go on to for the activities. And then, wherever we have the activities, and first and most important thing is the safety of our instructors. So, whenever they take the safety, and they are always instructed that you should be taking your safety first, and then going after the client, because they need to be also. And then once they come back from the activity, the feedback is always on a very high level. And then, wow, I have done this, I have done that, which I was actually having the fear of, I was scared of doing these activities, but then I have done that activity. This kind of feeling always gives us the pleasure of doing something for our clients safely. And why I am always using the safe word is adventure, as she was mentioning earlier. There were very few people those who were actually focusing on safety also, and then the program also. Nowadays, definitely safety is one of the most important things to follow. And that is how once they go through the activities, they give us a feedback of joining and enjoying and deciding.
When you say on field, one more thing I want to highlight. Many times, there's no set system for on field. It is spontaneous. We have a planned system. But when a client comes in for us, there is also a psychological part which we have to manage also. Because people are doing adventure first time, or somebody is done, and for him it is still, you know, something, it's a thrill, but it's still something to be scared about. So along with your technical management and everything, we have to balance the psycho of the participants also. That is, plays an important role on the planning an adventure is, firstly, we need to understand what the client wants. Understanding his capacity by talking to him. It could be physical, it could be mental as well. Secondly, what is he expecting out of adventure? Is it an amateur level adventure he's expecting, or he's already been on certain adventures and looking for high-end? For example, when you take Himalayan trips, a first timer can also go on a Himalayan trek. There are very simple treks like Kedar Kanta, Patalsu, which people can trek. They are 4 and 5 day treks. But for example, you take Everest Base Camp or you take Kailas Manas. We recommend Everest Base Camp, definitely we want people who have done one or two Himalayan treks. Kailas Manas also we recommend the same. So understanding the client. You may come to me saying, I want to do Everest Base Camp, but you've never trekked, even not in the Seyyar Hills. Then for me as a specialist, I need to tell you what is right for you and how you should prepare for it. That's important. Similarly, when it comes to rafting, somebody may say, I want to do Rishikesh rafting. But Rishikesh rafting is third or fourth level. Amateurs can very well do it. That's not a problem at all. But whether you can take it, so initially go to Kolar or the Dandeli, experience that and come, and then go to that level. So understanding the person, we have to have all the information with us so we can recommend that accordingly to their capacity in their life.
And they
can
come to the place also. Whenever they want to go for adventure camps, nowadays that's not for adventure camps. It's a lot of people. But then there is an age group in that particular age group. Some things are given for those age groups or only. Some things are for So we need to also tell parents that these things are not for this issue, and they can take these activities after a couple of years or so. Because they have to fix our community with us for some things, and if they are not able to, then that would be a problem for us for our social. From instructors to the client is also the most important thing, because all these activities are in a defined set rules. So if you follow the rules, nothing will going to happen, that's for sure. And if you follow those rules, then definitely the client will be no defending for you. So having checked the equipments, instructing clients on the rules, how to do the activities, and then checking that these people are doing the activities with the same rules. That's also the important thing.
Here I would like to restate in our part of it. When it comes to a passenger who wants to go adventure, from his point of view, I would say is we should see that the company he is going with is a known company following certain standards of operating adventure activities. There are many times I've seen we do children camps, and my experience for the last 10 years is parents will ask, kitne activities? It's very rarely, there are very few parents who will ask, what are the equipments you're using? What safety are you taking? Same thing, for example, a youngster wanting to go for rafting, he will look at the cost first. I understand cost is a criteria. But you have to realize, in a raft, there is a capacity of number of people to put there. There would be 7 to 8 people. I can reduce the cost and put 12 of you. But do you realize the load that comes and what your life is being put into danger? So any person going on an adventure, I would highly recommend, should check what is the safety norm for that activity, and the company, what is the company following those safety norms.
No regulatory boards till now as such. They're definitely for monitoring and then monitoring information is one of the body who actually sanctions or grant the expedition in Himalayas as well as the all the tracks for that matter also as well. But then they do not control as such. They approve the expedition or they approve the expedition. But then gradually is kind of a vision following whatever the rules are set, following those rules. That's kind of not that. But the Maharashtra is trying to do that thing. Obviously, the Minister of Rural Maharashtra. But then it's in the process, not at all, and not yet implemented as such. But then we have also seen this in the future that some government of Maharashtra will be regulating these things. They are working on those rules and regulations. Because I think there is not only mountaining or like a part of it, but there is an air adventure, there is a water adventure also, like water sports, then parasailing, skydiving. And then water sports, there are a lot of things for that goes there, checks goes there. So, hydrography is there. So, there are different adventure aspects of what we call the law, land, air, water, and that sports. Coordinating all different area stations and institutes, they are, and this is under process, but then we are ready for that. And that will definitely channelize the adventure tourism in Maharashtra, subsequently from India as well. Yes, definitely, government of Uttaranchal, Uttarakhand government, and city government, where we are doing whitewater rafting, they do have licenses for running the whitewater rafting activity. But then, obviously, here also, because it's people having blood also, we have the license. Associations and they have license to do this activity. But then, other than these things, people are certified, like you were mentioning, ID certification, and then you can take scuba diving courses or scuba diving courses. But then, typically for monitoring, if you have all these kinds of certifications for higher certification from all one of the four institutes, that would be advisable as such. But then, they do not tell you that you are already. This is not license as such. This is a certainty of what you can say and you are able to do mountaining activities.
To start an agency, there are no licenses.
No licenses.
That is why it's very important. See, when you have a license, you are rest assured. Since there is no license, this is one of the most travel, adventure, all it said, is a very disorganized sector. Now the government is trying to come up with certain things. So that's why when you're booking with anybody, you need to be more alert about it. We both have worked earlier, not in an adventure, like mine is a travel background, but 23 years of travel, corporate travel, with my 10 years with the Bajaj Group Travel Agency, started from scratch and grew to head of the agency. And Chandan is a chemical engineer who's worked with BRC for 10 years. So my travel and his adventure experience, after working so long, when we met, we thought of starting this agency. And my experience in the travel field has helped me in my company quite a bit. His field experience has complemented the company quite a bit. So together between the two of us, we've added 15 plus years of experience.
Thank you to know people. I mean, across India, when we travel right from Ladakh area to Gujarat, to Eastern Bihar, to Sikkim, and then southern part of India. So we got a lot of different friends who come from different culture, different geographical area also as well. So I'm not able to speak their language, but then heart-to-heart connection is important for us. And then obviously, you know, that going to those places and exploring those places for our knowledge also, and obviously understand their culture, not only a small extent, that I don't personally like. And obviously, being on field, you are always on those. So, I love being on field.
I love travel, and it's not just restricted to me. I like to send people on travel also. Then it could be adventure, it could be a safari, any kind of an experience. I remember my ex-MD telling me, Kiran Bajaj, when I was working with Bajaj, that it's very easy to understand what a foreigner wants. He'll tell you, I want to do this. But understanding what an Indian wants, half of the time they only don't know what they want. So scoping that out and giving them that experience gives me the kick, basically. And of course, connecting with people, like I can very easily say that there are many places in India where I know at any given time I have somebody to call. So we've connected with so many people on different levels, and a family all over India in small pockets we have. There are major challenges, trust me. I won't say just from a business point of view, but even from the client or passenger or the participant point of view, there are, like we just highlighted, there are no licenses to start an agency. So in the last 5 years, what we have seen a change is anybody who's been on one trip will open his adventure. The worst thing is when we are on field, we have seen certain times we have our own equipment, which is imported, majorly imported equipment which we use, because we know the person is risking his life, he's actually handing over his life to me, that I bring him down so safely from that single rope. So it's my duty to make sure that rope has that capacity, my duty to make sure he's wearing the right harness. And I've seen operators on field where forget a harness, they will just put a rope around and bring the person down. So frankly, this is a big challenge, and that's why I again and again tell people, please check who you're going with for the activity. And with adventure, don't put price as a bar. There are many times a client will ask me, we do even corporate team building activities. Thoda price kam karo. I said, theek hai, main kam karke safety rope nikal deti hu. Chalega aapko? Which is a fact, if I don't have an activity, mein safety rope nahi hai. वो मेन रोप चलो सब इज द बेस्ट क्वालिटी आई एम यूजिंग बट यू नेवर नो व्हाट विल हैपन एन एडवेंचर इज समथिंग व्हिच हैपेंस इन नेचर सो नेचर इज चैलेंजिंग अस एवरी नाउ एंड देन सो वी हैव टू बी रेडी सो देयर मे बी अ टाइम वेयर यू नीड दैट सेफ्टी रोप दैट एटलीस्ट साइकोलॉजिकली यू आर सेफ ओवर देयर एंड देयर हैव बीन इंसिडेंसेस वेयर द सेफ्टी रोप नो एक्सीडेंट टच वुड इन द लास्ट 18 इयर्स थैंक्स टू गॉड वी हैवंट हैड. And I hope this continues. But for example, I can tell you an incident wherein we were doing a waterfall rappel. And that girl started the waterfall rappel. Chandan was on the edge. No, his team was on the edge. She started rappeling, and after 5 feet, she said, No, I'm not going down. She had to go another 130 feet. No, I will not go down. Now, the way rappeling, I don't know if anyone has done, the way rappeling is, you will go down only. I can't pull you up on the rappelling rope. Then Chandan came, spoke to her, tried to explain to her. She said, no. Now, we without safety, we don't work at all. May it be my team or the participants. Chandan spoke to her. She refused to go down. She was so scared. She just didn't know her right and left also. So together, they pulled her up with the help of the safety rope or the rescue rope, that is. Okay, I'd like to share another joke on this also. She sat down for some time, saw two of her friends go down, and she said, I want to go again. So we said, are you sure? She said, yes. So this time Chandan said, I will stand at the edge and send her down. She starts rappelling again at the same spot. No, I will not go down. Mama, she started to scream. Finish. Over there we both decided, she's going down. We are not pulling her up this time. She managed to complete the rappelling, but my point over here is if we didn't have the safety rope, there would be a problem. So, that's it. In initial years, we used to make a lot of time. It used to be like, spontaneous, get up in the morning and let's go in this direction, check out what's there to do, go and do a rafting and come back. Maybe sometimes when you make your passion your profession, sending people, you get so busy doing that, you know, that yes, your travel does reduce. Last 2 years, we made it a focus that no, we will go out. Like, I've planned that scuba diving is something which we have launched this year with TAGI certification. So, I have planned to do that either in May or I will be doing it in October. So, Chandan has started doing treks often. And just a thought I shared with him the other day, I said, why do we need to go on 4,000 feet also? Trekking is climbing a mountain. So another thought which has come to us is we are planning to form a club in Thane, where any trek lover can just join the club and we go up the mountain and come down. So this is how we are trying to fit in our busy schedule, our passion, and of course then we get to meet people as well.
I don't see a specialist as such, but because there are every now and then there are a lot of individuals coming in for different equipment. Like when we were doing almost 95 or in the 90s, we were implementing YouTube Live week or something. That time we were using the equipment on a different scale. Nowadays there are so many different equipment involved up continuously coming up in the market. So you need to able to use those equipments also for the activities. But importantly, getting out of your comfort zone, going in the wild, doing things which you have earlier not done or rather nobody has done also earlier. So those are the things. Obviously afterwards you can bring the qualification after consuming more of this.
I would like to highlight one thing. Your multitasking has to be done. Because there are a lot of things you need to coordinate. Secondly, your communication coordination. Because from the client to your supplier or a partner over there, you're coordinating. Thirdly, empathy. Because you know adventure, so you don't think you know it all. The opposite person doesn't know. So having empathy is extremely important. And lastly, most important, keeping a cool head. If you are cool-headed, you will think proper and do the right thing for your clients. Here I would like to a little different point of view. Yes, 5 years, 10 years back, yes, this was not the first time. But currently, the young generation loves traveling. They want that thrill and they are looking for it. So there's a total change in the scenario which has happened in the past 5 to 7 years. We have campers who are coming with us. We do summer camps. So campers who are coming with us who are now consulting us, how can I do a career in adventure? So there is a change and parents are at times worried. How will the child manage? Adventure is risky, travel is risky, especially girls. Parents do tell us and how can they make that career. It's not just adventure. Where we are doing National Defence Academy camps. I can tell you last year out of 150 students, 2 students decided to join military. So current generation has so many options and they are aware of a lot of things. Secondly, when we were children, no, I don't remember having travelled to places much. But if you see the current family, every year, they take 2 holidays. So children are aware about it. So if a parent, a child is interested in making a career, there are certain things which the child has to do, like a certain education we should pick, we would recommend. Because like maybe it's old school thinking, but that's how we have been taught that, in qualification aap le lo and expand with your career in that direction. Of course, there are certain, like Chandan mentioned, qualifications to be taken, certain ground experience to be taken, which will take you forward in this career. And it's very safe. It's very safe.
As I mentioned, basically, upgrading yourself to the college, correct? But importantly, from this, we have to put the space from the business but then we definitely need to add some points where maybe some different kind of incidents or added model also as well.
One more thing I would like to highlight in this secondly what Chandra said is differently, nowadays everybody wants something different all the way. We may not know everything as an adventure. You'll say you should know, but there's so much happening, so many changes happening every now and then. So if you get a call from anybody for any activity, I don't think so my office has ever said, sorry, I don't know this, we'll check it. We will find out and give them that information. So we cater to every adventure and travel.
Lost his way down the road and he's not able to find out the correct path. So he will then follow and stop up in somewhere else. So I can and he doesn't even have his mobile number. So you know, I call that person and I actually ask him what are the exact locations after asking the geographical features where he is actually stopping. And then what he was writing is he was just going exactly into the opposite direction of wherever he actually supposed to do. And then I made it a point and asked him the features that these are now here, left side of my channel, from that place. And then he could find out from my friend's place and then he guided him through the route. So, probably as you were mentioning, you know, please confirm wherever you are going and please consult with some people those who are experienced. But then we never say no to these kind of situations. People are stuck.
And don't rely on people.
Because kind of your distance, I mean, it will give you the distance, the time, but not the arrival as such, you know, on the map. So that could be kind of a disadvantage.
We are into corporate team building activities. So corporates, you know, have their rigid way. They have, you know, this is what I want. I don't do this kind of an activity. So when in team building activities, we address that. And there are times we also have the adventure activities. And it could be a serious training or it's for the fun. So we have done one program for business and shipping. And this is our second program. The HR head number. First time also we did adventure activities, team building activities. But she refused to do grappling. She said, she's scared, I'm not going to do it. Second group when we did for her, we told her that no, you have to experience it because it was on a serious training which we had done that where you gain confidence, how you trust the system. These are certain things we are doing. So if you as an HR head don't experience it, it will be difficult for you to, you know, put it across to your team. I still remember that experience. She refused to do it finally. I told her if you want, I tell Chandra to grapple down with it. No. Then Chandan spoke to her. Then she said, okay, but you will not let me fall. You know, this typical thing. I have done grappling up to 350 feet. Even today, if I stand, any human being stands at 40 feet also. And you look down and you just have to rely on the rope. It is still scary. So it's for every one of us. It's only for you to overcome your that fear. That first step you need to take. And that was a challenge for her, for us with Namrita. I still remember Chandan was on another rope next to her, talking to her continuously. We had finished rapping for everyone, every other participant, because we knew this was going to be time. And I don't know how and when, where she quit. But after 10 minutes of talking, I think she got fed up of listening to Chandan. She took the first step down. She refused to give up. She took the first step down and then she had to go down. She kept screaming, talking to Chandan. Chandan, will I reach safely? Simultaneously, Chandan was down. And the best part was at the end of the rapping, she had that, you know, a sense of achievement. She was like, wow, I could do this, but I'm not doing it again.
which she has learned. Like I mentioned to you, the kick which you get is when somebody gets that experience and said, you know, something for himself. This is a fun experience for learning for us also. Like I told you, for us, it's not just doing the activity. It's psychologically understanding, empathizing with that person and making him do the right.
She mentioned that we got married in the water. But she didn't tell you how we made it. We made on Palamakar and Rajkar trips. And probably that time, we are the first people and the proposal on the Pandong.
Before
Abhay Khan. Kind of proposal we made Karina on Pandong in 3 years. And then, last year when we came on the Rajkar. Actually, on the rock which was submerged underwater. Now, this time we came out of the water. And I could recollect that I was in nostalgic, I was in the first time and super scared. But that's kind of a completely different experience. But using the love one on 45 feet on the bank of Pandong Bay. And those times we were not allowed to stay on the bank of Pandong Bay. But we were supposed to come in from there around 50 km and then stay in that. But then that is kind of personal experience. And one more important thing, another experience is when we do adventure camps for kids, there are a lot of kids who are pampered, single child probably, and then they always want to have what they have. They get what they want. But here in camps, when we do camping, we always tell parents that these are like, they're based on 4 pillars of mankind or the children. So, kind of a taking responsibility. Everybody has to do all their own, all the activities or morning rituals or whatever the things they want to do, dependent on the parent, how they have to do on their own. One girl, I think Pranuti Kawar from Korea, we were taking the feedbacks from every child. And the best feedback was that she mentioned that I'm a very fussy person. I always say that things are not in favor of me. But then here, whenever I was having a dialogue or an activity, I was not satisfied because they were not listening to me and I was used to get angry. But then now, after 4 years, I have learned how to control my anger and definitely I will try and do that because that will help me in the future. So, these kind of events always give us encouragement that we should do not meeting and major camps for children so that we are at least in their life. Some different aspect in their life, we are playing an active role.
I think every child has taken something away and given us something from the camps. It's very close to heart. From Leha, I want to highlight as an experience. When you are planning to come into adventure or travel field, educating your client is very important. For example, when we do Leh Ladakh, for us that's an adventure tour because we are crossing high altitude. When you do Khartoum, there's 18,000 feet, 40 feet. There is a board over there put up which says that you shouldn't wait there more than 15 minutes because the oxygen level is very low. Very few people I have seen, if they go independently or with anybody. But, you know, the fascination that I've come to this height and taking pictures, don't realize the time now. So, telling your clients these things, if you're with, on the tour, making sure sometimes you have to be back. But it's for their good, you know. So being that, a funny part of it is part of education only is you should tell your clients when you're traveling to such places. It's long distance travel, it's dry weather. They say that in Ladakh, at a time you could get a sunstroke and you could get a frostbite. So you can imagine at 11,000 feet is Ladakh, you're going up to 18,340. That distance is only 50 kilometers, but it takes you 2 to 3 hours because it's entire from 11,000 to 2,000. You have to realize whenever you take these trips, there are no toilets throughout both. So that's something we always tell our clients. Go to Ladakh to love nature. If you're the kind who looks up, arey ye wapas wahi mountain hai, don't go. You love nature, you love mountains, go to that place and please be prepared. This is not like a city where you're going to get toiletry facilities everywhere.
So it's a little funny, but it's a fact which you need to educate your client. And luckily we tell people this, so then it becomes like a joke also. We have to go in nature, which city people are not used to it. So mentally they are prepared, then they look at it as a, you know, like a fun part of it and enjoy yourself. Most importantly, you have to love meeting people. This is a people industry where people connecting with people. You have to have a cool temperament because you have to meet all kinds of people. Secondly, when you're planning, you have to be the kind who loves to plan, because without planning you can't execute it right. So you have to be into wanting to plan things properly. That's when you will give a good experience to people. In spite of planning, this field is such that things can go wrong. So that's the reason I again repeat, be cool-headed, because you should be able to handle any situation. I'll share an experience on this also. I was coming back from South Africa with a group of 187 people. I had a batch of, Chandan was with me on that group also. I had a batch of 87 people. They were from different parts of India who were coming to Bombay. We came from Cape Town to Johannesburg. We had to change the flight and come back from South Africa, Johannesburg to Bombay. Firstly, for some reason, South Africa airports are a mess. They had printed all 87 boarding cards and then they couldn't find the names. So we were all behind the counter finding out boarding passes for the right people. So that took up time. People crossed security and they said, you can't keep this apple. So there was a bunch of 87 apples out there. So everybody had to remove them. But the most serious thing, and I think that's what we kept really cool, is we stood in the immigration queue. And one of the dealers comes and tells me, ma'am, gadbad ho gaya. Said, we used to always take the last check. So I said, what happened? He said, wo mera bhai hai na, uske paas mera passport hai. Usne immigration cross kiya. Uska passport mere paas. Now if we were there, I would have started shouting at him, how could you do this? What did you do to finish? That guy would be finished there itself. So we said, no, there's nothing we can do about it. I said, you coolly go. Then you give the passport, keep your finger on your photograph and give it to them. And you look elsewhere. Nothing else I can tell him. There's nothing I can do about it. And if I had given him a solution that, go call your brother, then we'll tell the immigration officer. We were already delayed. Our flight was to take off in the next 40 minutes. And I had another 40 people behind me, which I couldn't risk up. By God's grace, he passed immigration and we all came back safely. My point here is keeping your cool is very important.
They should be assessing the situation very fast. When you should be understanding the situation, who is going first, who is going good, or where to stop the activity, where to complete the activity. That is the most important thing. Even if your client is, you know, forcing you to do the activities, you being an adventure expert or an adventure, you know, political or adventure organizer, you should be able to understand what are the things which are in your favor and what are the things which are not in your favor. So, keeping client safety and importantly your safety also to keep in mind, you should be assessing the situation very fast and implementing your knowledge or implementing your actions on that. That is the most important thing. What we always say, because I can also share with you one instance that when we were doing whatever happened, and it was a very heavy rain, like 6 July, a few days back.
First time we saw cloud burst.
Yeah, that was kind of a cloud burst over there. And when we actually reached the site, it was like comfortable water was there. And kind of white water. But then, as the day started rising up, started pouring the water very much. And we could not see the face behind the water coming. It was like completely muddy water, and then we had to actually immediately stop the water for that. It was a lot of small,
pebbles,
but it was also in the water. So, people were actually stopping, they wanted to do water for that, but then we actually stopped it because concerning their safety. Because even if you were helping at that, all the safety gears, you know, we didn't want to take any chances. We had to let them know we are stopping to go further. So that's the most important thing.
Yeah, because the 2 feet waterfall had become into a 10 feet. Anybody could get suffocated and die. So it's for us to take. Sometimes that is a bit of the limits also at times. But this is very important. Also, one more thing I would recommend to students who are planning a career, especially in adventure, travel also, both I would say, please do a first aid course. It will personally also help you, but we are both first aiders ourselves. Our team also, we make sure that we get trained for first aid. This adventure, like you just shared with you, anything, anytime could happen. You have to take care of yourself and your people. I will repeat, yourself and your people. It's not only the participant. If you are safe, you will take care of it. You have to realize that. In travel also, it helps you. Personally, it will help you also at home. You know, nowadays at home also, what things are happening. You don't know, anything can happen. But as an adventure or a travel operator, you should do a first aid course and update yourself regularly.